somewhere around fourth grade, I realized that Saturn was not going to impact my life and I didn't care about it.
I'm 42 years old and I swear on everything I've got, I feel like I'm just starting, and everything that people think I am and what I've accomplished and all that is in my own head, because I'm like, I haven't even started. If you're not capable or willing to up your game, put in the work, hustle, you should lose.
Need motivation?
Watch a top 10 with Believe Nation.
What's up, Believe Nation? It's Evan. My one word is believe, and I believe in you. I believe you have Michael Jordan level talent at something, and I want you to find it, embrace it, and use it to make a difference. So let's get your motivation to a 10 and get you believing in you. Grab a snack and chew on today's lessons from a man who went from being born in the Soviet Union, coming to America, being a lemonade stand entrepreneur, eventually helping his father grow his wine business from $3 million to $60 million, and now wanting to become one of the greatest entrepreneurs of his generation. He's Gary Vaynerchuk, and here's my take on his Top 10 Rules to Success, Volume 7. Enjoy. Okay, let's kick it off with rule number one, be self-aware.
I was really unusual Eastern European immigrant that came during that time. Every one of my parents' friends' kids were straight A students because education was the way out. If you go to Instagram literally right now and look at my account, Gary VEE, two posts ago I posted my high school report card because nobody believes me, but I was a straight DNF student. Somewhere around fourth grade, I realized that Saturn was not going to impact my life and I didn't care about it. And so, self-awareness is a son of a bitch, you know, and honestly, besides health, for everybody in this room, I wish you self-awareness, because once you understand who you are, you can do a lot of damage. All of us suck at a lot of stuff. All of us are good at a lot of stuff. The game is to figure that out. Through good parenting, through circumstance, through who knows really what, got very self-aware very early in my life. And listen, at 13, you know, listen, it was tough for my friends' parents to say I was a loser because I got D's and F's. It wasn't fun for my teachers to say that I wasn't gonna amount to anything. Here was my biggest problem. I was 13 years old. I was making $3,000 a weekend selling baseball cards. I had $47,000 in cash under my bed, and I wasn't selling weed. I thought I was amazing.
Rule number two, just do it.
You're asking a different question. You're asking, when's the time to jump in the pool?
Yeah.
When's the time to kiss the boy?
Uh-huh.
When's the time, you know, to get married? You know, you're talking about, like, when's the time to take the training wheels off the bike?
Uh-huh.
You know?
Yeah.
When's the time to live your life? That's probably why I make content. The answer is, I don't know. Nobody knows.
Yeah.
There's no right answer. There's that moment in time.
Yeah, I see.
This is why I produce content every day. You might be watching my content every day. And it might be this conversation with us in the vlog that is, you know, that's very meta. This might have been the one. This might have been the one. On this day, because of a conversation you had last night, because of the weather outside, because of a news headline, because of the patterns of how the four Instagram posts came in your feed, it might just be the time you finally do what the f*** you're supposed to do. And I think a lot of people think of it as like, quit your job and go do your journey, right? Things you're thinking about, others. I think of it a little bit different.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's...
impracticality.
That's exactly right. Sometimes it's like, I've been doing this nightlife and t-shirt thing for 7 years. Why don't I go work for something smart for a year, reset?
Mm-hmm.
Why don't I go travel? Why don't I sell my home that I don't use 90% of, take that money, get an apartment, and then do something with that money? So to me, it's not just like the fancy sizzle of like, now jump into the rest of your life. It's also like audit, understand what you need, break up with that person, marry that person,
you know,
start your career, go back to corporate for an hour, aka a year or two, to reset, you know?
I see.
Just do.
Yeah.
It's the indecisiveness. It's the indecisiveness that is the poison.
Okay.
Because you can always undo.
Yeah, that's true.
the biggest thing about doing is the undoing that people don't see.
Yeah.
I'm always like, okay, good. And then like, if you fail, go back. But people don't want the scarlet letter. They don't want the judgment. This is why you have to tune everything out. Because if you can go and judge, start your t-shirt brand or your pin brand or your video blog and it fails, if you just think you can go back to it, well, that sounds cool.
Yeah.
But if you feel like, oh, but then everybody's gonna clown on me and say, like then you're, if you're pessimistic mom's gonna be like, see, I told you you could never do it. If you can't get over that,
yeah,
then you're stuck.
Rule number three, don't let anyone dictate your game.
And I think there's an enormous amount of confusion in the system for 28-year-olds about where they are in life. I think the
that's my biggest problem I've been having lately. And that's I've been watching a lot of you and watching a lot of your videos and a lot of things that you do and all kinds of other stuff. And it's helped me kind of come out and realize, you know, my time is when I ever find it. I got my own clock.
100, bro, honestly, no joke, I feel like you're closer to 2.8 years old than the way you think about 28. Like, you've got 60 years of execution in front of you. That's like two full lives more of execution. And the problem with 28 is 28's a tricky thing. 28's tricky. 28 is too many people up, because I'm telling you that looking at 30, like, wait a minute, it's like, oh, 30's here. Shouldn't I quote unquote have my life together? You know, and then at 28, you got, you know, 5 to 50% of your friends that you went to high school or college with that are like, you know, getting married, having, you know, getting somewhere in their life, da da da. Don't let anybody else's clock, you know, dictate your game. Like, at, you know, 28 is early as dude, honestly, brother, I'll shoot it straight to you. I'm 42 years old and I swear on everything I've got, I feel like I'm just starting, and everything that people think I am and what I've accomplished and all that is in my own head, because I'm like, I haven't even started. So imagine what I think about you at 28.
Rule number four, chase underpriced attention.
My entire career, what allows me to be here today, what allows me to dream and be audacious about owning a professional football team is very simple. I chase underpriced attention. I chase properly priced attention, and I completely punt overpriced attention. Simple. I know that everybody in this room does things for 8 to 10 hours a day, every day of the day, of the week, the month, the year, on things that no longer bring as much value as it did 6, 9, 14 years ago that helped you get to this point. I know that there's somebody in this room that if they started a B2B podcast, I know that if somebody in this room who had never thought about producing content or media, if they started a podcast, which they don't even have the beginnings of a thought of how to do that right now, but the good news is you literally go to Google and you type in, how do I start a podcast? I know that if somebody here started a podcast for this industry and put out an episode every week and interviewed a thought leader in this industry, that even though only 700 to 1500 people would listen to it, because it's obviously very niche in its content, that it would be the differentiator of growing their business, that it would lead to lead gen, that there are people that they're trying to chase to get the account that in turn a year later would be chasing them to be a guest on the show, which then would inevitably lead to them getting the business. My friends, please understand over the next period of time as I talk to you about some of these nuances that I am not a technologist, that had I not been in business, that I wouldn't want to have necessarily an Instagram or Snapchat or LinkedIn account. It doesn't come natural to me. It's not necessarily what I want. What I want is to sell stuff. What I want is to run a successful business. What I want is to win. And to me, if you sit in this room and you do not realize how extreme the internet technology revolution actually is, you become vulnerable.
Rule number five, up your game.
You're not gonna change evolution and technology. You just need to figure out how to ride it so it doesn't kill you. And by the way, I mean this, I'm, you know, collecting the energy of the room, thinking about what we talked about here. I mean this, I don't think it's bad. If you're not capable or willing to up your game, put in the work, hustle, you should lose. It's how you won. But everybody fights hard for 30 years and then wants to hold up. Athletes, You know what I hate about business that I love about athletes? When you're the best athlete in the world, you get the results. When you get to 36 and a younger lion comes along, you lose. In business, we have this weird bullshit that we're supposed to be rewarded at the end. F you. I mean it. F you. You didn't take this internet serious for the last 20 years. Why the f should you be rewarded?
Rule number 6, do something with your life.
Pay the f attention to who's giving you the advice. Who's giving the advice? And more importantly, if you live your life where you're comfortable taking somebody else's point of view on how you should live your life, you deserve to lose. It's bullshit, because when you listen to outside voices, you're always going to regret it. My question is very simple. Would you rather appease the inconvenience right now in the short term, or do you want to sit around as a 78-year-old and regret how you lived your life? That's the basic question. Are you willing to take the short-term lack of pain by conforming to the system? Or do you actually want to do something with your life? Because this internet thing, the fact that there's 3 cameras in this room right now, the fact that 1 million people almost on Instagram follow you, like this is available. There is so much abundance in the system. Everybody can get there.
Rule number 7, don't make excuses.
If you're trying to reach the decision maker at a retail organization, that guy or gal is also the same person that I want to reach to sell a bottle of wine or a book to. And that space in his and her Facebook feed is only one space. So that is supply and demand. I used to buy that space 4 years ago for $1 for every 1,000 impressions. Now it's 7. The longer you think this world doesn't exist and you fearmonger it, the longer you don't put money in, the longer I can extract all the value. I've lived this game. I'm not a hero because I took it from 3 to 50 million, 60 million, my dad's business. I actually am a schmuck. I should have spent more on Google. I had it figured out. Every time you typed in Cabernet, Merlot, Silver Oak, Camus, Napa, Bordeaux, I was showing up first because nobody realized it was good real estate. And it was only costing me 5 or 10 cents a click. And I was making between $7 and $80 in profit for something that was costing me $3 to get you through the funnel on the average of 60 people coming and 1 converting. I was stupid. I'm being serious with you. I stand here and have passion about LinkedIn and Facebook marketing in a B2B environment today out of regret for what I did from 2002 to 2005, because I should have spent more. It was basic math, but I just didn't understand because I was young in my career, and it just, I don't even know how to explain it to you. When it's too good to be true, it's too good to be true, right? I'm an immigrant, I was cynical, I just didn't, plus I also thought it was important to do direct mail and local commercials and magazine. I was doing it all, but in hindsight, it was the great mistake of my career. The great mistake of my career was not spending more money on Google. And I promise you, the great mistake of your accelerated growth for the 80% that just raised their hand is not taking advertising on LinkedIn and Facebook seriously because you don't think your person is on it. I've heard guys, I've been doing this for 10 years. I know what your excuse is gonna be. I can't wait to the Q&A. I'm gonna stand here and wanna, but Gary, my target person is a 63-year-old man. He's not on it. Bullshit. Of course he's on it. Who do you think is spreading all the Democratic and Republican propaganda on Facebook?
Rule number 8, know your goal.
The biggest reason I think people are struggling with social media, literally people are pandering to a like on an Instagram post, not on necessarily what they're trying to do. So I think first and foremost, at a macro, you need to understand, are you actually building your business to sell it? Because then you may care about, you know, the EBITDA and how much profit you're making, and so that advice is important. VaynerMedia is gonna do $170 million, and I'm not gonna make a penny. Like, I'm trying to pour it all back in. Literally, we may make zero profit this year, and it's because I don't want to sell it tomorrow, and I don't need the dividends from the profits in a year to change my lifestyle. So I mean this, it's really important. You have to know what you're doing and like why you're doing it. And by the way, you can change your mind. You could be sitting here and be like, I'm gonna change the world, you know, great. And then in 2 years you wanna buy an island, that's great, and everything in between. So first, what?
Rule number 9, my personal favorite, build self-belief.
If someone wasn't raised in that environment with that self-belief, How does one develop that for themselves?
Surrounding themselves by people that do it for them, or consuming content that does it for them.
Penetrating people's skulls and reframing their game. Their mom told them they were a loser. I'm telling them they're a winner. I think I can outmarket their mom. Their mom had a big head start and a whole lot of like emotional, like physiological advantages. But guess what? Give me 18 months of your time. Give me 2 hours a day. I'll make you realize your mom and go do your thing. That's what I'm up to.
And rule number 10, the last one before a very special bonus clip, have patience.
I made content every day for 9 years before it started really happening.
Okay.
It's not sexy, it's just basic, but it works. And you've got the skill, you've got craft. And there's a lot of people that have craft. So you have to chip.
Yeah.
You know? One day, one post, something cool, and somebody cool, Drake sees it, does it, and everything changes.
Yeah.
But you have to do it every day to have that moment.
Now I've got a really special Gary V bonus clip on how to work your face off that I think you're gonna enjoy. But before that, question of the day, I wanna know which of these two rules spoke to you more, build your self-belief or don't make excuses. Let me know in the comments below. Thank you guys so much for watching. I believe in you. I hope you continue to believe in yourself and whatever your one word is. Much love. I'll see you soon and enjoy the bonus clip.
I was born in Belarus in the former Soviet Union. I came to the US when I was 3. We lived a very humble beginning. As you can imagine, the economy wasn't super great. We didn't speak English. We had $100. I lived with 7 family members in a studio apartment in Queens. So it was super humble. Obviously my parents are very much my heroes. One, because my mom is the greatest parent of all time, and 2, because my dad worked his face off, and even though I slept under the same roof literally every day of my life with my dad in the first 14 years of my life, I literally never saw him because he left at 7 a.m. or 6 a.m. and he came home at 10 p.m. and he worked 7 days a week. How many people here are immigrants or children of immigrants? Raise your hands. Awesome. So this group that just raised their hands, they know that immigrants in America have absolutely figured out one of the core secrets, which is, you know, work your face off and don't buy dumb shit. And so that's kind of what my family did for 7 or 8 years. You know, my dad wasn't making that much money, but a funny thing happens when you buy nothing but food at the lowest possible price. And save, and very quickly, only 6 years after coming to America with $100, my dad was able to buy a small liquor store in New Jersey. We moved to New Jersey. That is where my entrepreneurial career began. When I was 6, I had a 5 lemonade stand franchise. I manipulated my friends into standing behind the lemonade all day. And that is when I became obsessed with attention. And this is really interesting. As you can see up here, I day trade attention, culture, and build businesses. At 6 years old, I would spend my summer days literally walking up and down the streets of New Jersey, sitting down on the curb, watching cars drive by so that I could figure out which tree or post was better for me to put a sign that said lemonade a quarter. That is DNA. That's like somebody singing, that's like somebody throwing a pitch, really, like that is just pure DNA. I didn't read a Seth Godin book or go to Harvard Business School to figure out that attention was the number one asset. The one thing that combines every person here, from the cameramen back there who are producing, to the industry that is in this room, to me, to Mickey, to anybody else that sneaked in, the one thing that fundamentally connects all of us is before you tell me how great your product and service is, you need my attention so that I listen. I am obsessed with attention. I am obsessed with this device because it has the attention. I am unemotional if it's ruining the kids and they don't know how to engage, or that you are sad that people go out to dinner and don't talk to each other. Technology does not care about your feelings. And so I, as a human, may have some opinions about parenthood and society and privacy as a human, but as a businessman, I am unemotional and not romantic. All I do is follow where the attention is, and I figure out how to storytell in there to create the action that I desire.
If you tell yourself a story long enough, you start to believe it. And once you believe it, you act like it.
I have tussled with a whale, out of handcuffed lightning, throw thunder in jail. Now you know I'm bad. Only last week, I murdered a rock, injured a stone, hospitalized a brick. I'm so mean, I make medicine sick.
The fundamental key to success is...
It can take between 18 and 254 days of taking action for a new habit to stick. I've created a new course called 254 Confidence, where every single day for 254 days, I will be sending you a video between 30 seconds and 5 minutes long that you start your morning with around making you feel confident. It's absolutely free. Check out the link in the description below to get access.